Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to integrate an AdMob banner ad into a .NET MAUI app using the plugin AdMob Nuget package. Quick disclaimer, I'm the author of this open source plugin and this video will be focused around it. There are other plugins available as well, choose the one that best fits your needs. I'll be starting with a basic .NET MAUI app that targets both Android and iOS. Make sure your app builds and runs on both platforms before continuing. Now let's bring in the AdMob plugin. To do that, open the Nuget package manager for your project and search for plugin AdMob, then install it into the project. This will automatically reference the required native AdMob SDKs for Android and iOS. Next, we need to tell our app to initialize the plugin. We do so by going to our MAUI program file and calling useAdMob on the app builder. Once we've done that, we need to do some platform-specific setup. Let's start with Android. Open up your Android manifest file and let's make the following changes. First up, we need to register the AdMob ad activity. Next, we configure our application ID. And last, we make sure that the permissions for network access are in place. You can find these setup instructions and fully working samples linked below the video, so don't worry about typing them in by hand. Let's move on to iOS. Open up your info plist file and modify it to include the GAD application identifier and SK ad network items as described in the iOS Quick Start Guide. You can find the link to it in the video description. In the same file, we also need to add the GAD is ad manager app key as well and set it to true. Next, we move to the app delegate file. Here we need to call the start method on the AdMob SDK's shared instance. And last, we need to enable Swift library linking by adding the following custom link flags in the CS project file. And that's it. We're done with the setup. Now, let's finally add the banner ad to the main page of our app. We'll start by including the AdMob namespace at the top of the page. Then we'll tweak the layout a bit by switching the scroll viewer to a grid and adding a row at the bottom which automatically sizes itself based on its content. With that in place, we can go ahead and drop in our banner ad. To make sure it adjusts nicely to different screen sizes, we'll set the ad size to Smart Banner. Finally, we'll configure the ad unit ID. If you're targeting multiple platforms like I am, you can use the OnPlatform class to provide different ad unit IDs depending on the platform you're running on. Before we run the app, let's configure the plugin to use test ads by setting the adconfig use test ad unit IDs to true while in debug mode. This ensures you're safe from policy violations during development. Now run the app on either an Android emulator or iOS physical device. The plugin automatically handles consent for you, so if everything is wired up correctly, you should see a privacy consent form. Once you've clicked on the consent button, an ad should load at the bottom of the screen on both platforms. And that's it! You now have AdMob banner ads running in your .NET MAUI app for both Android and iOS using plugin AdMob. If this was helpful, check out the plugin on GitHub. The link is in the description.